Welcome everybody to this tutorial. Today I'm going to go over a few more commands with you. The first one that we shall deal with is the command man. So man actually is basically a manual or man pages for a specific command. So for example, you can type in man ls and it's going to tell you everything that there is to know about the ls command. Sometimes the help part of the command, so ls dash dash help, is not formulated to the best and you get a list of arguments, but for example you don't get the description of what each one of those arguments does. You only get the syntax of the command and how you should type it in, but you don't really know how it actually, what will a certain argument do to the command, how will it modify it. Man pages also have a help menu, so if I just type in man dash help dash dash help, you see that I have a lot of options here. Most of these things are actually related to the search part, to searching through man pages or to searching for the right portions of the man pages and formatting their output. But I didn't really find it necessary over the course of the years to use most of these. Basically, man and a certain command will suffice. Anyway, aside from that, I would recommend that you just go ahead and read through them just to see what options you have. You don't need to memorize them as you always have them in the help bar, but just have a look at it and that will be sufficient. It's a good thing to know how to use man pages and just to know that they are there so that you can refer to another source if the help menu doesn't actually suffice. Let's just go ahead and clear the screen. The next command which I wanted to deal with you is touch. Touch is used for creating files. And in combination with this, I will also teach you how you can actually search through your system for a certain file. Now usually there are two methods. One is preferred over the other. For example, you have locate. And so very simple, plain English language, and you have find. Now locate is a lot faster than find, but it does require the database to be updated. And don't get intimidated right away, there is not, the process of updating the database is basically one word command, that's it. Anyway, before we get into that, let's just go ahead and see how touch works. So touch, and let's say that I want to create file one. So this is just a reference name that I'm creating. You can basically smash your keyboard here and name your file. There are some limitations as to how you can name your file, but generally you can pretty much name it to anything within pretty much anything that suits you. So let's create, let's use file one. Let's do it like this, file 01. And if I press enter and then if I list it, you can see that the file 101 is there. But look, there is a shortcut to the ls. If you don't want to do this ls space dash l for the long listing, which is generally more preferable than just the ls, you can simply use the ll command. And if you use the ll command, by default you will be given a long listing for that directory. LL works pretty much the same as LS, so you just type in LL. You can also specify a path, so let's say through the root, simple as that, and you can also say LL-R-root. You see, it gives a recursiveness here, so it works in the same way, except you just tab L twice and press enter and get a long listing. It saves you a ton load of time, trust me on that one. Anyway, we have created file one, but we can also create multiple files like this, as it is a rather fast way of doing that. So we just do touch, and you can also specify a directory where you want the files to be created. For example, I can go ahead and type in downloads, and then I can say, I don't know, file 02. Downloads, file 03, and then I can change the directory path. I can say, okay, now I want you to go to documents, and I'm gonna say file. Oops, I messed it up with a 03. I'm gonna fix this shortly. I can say here file 04. So it gives you the ability to create files pretty much anywhere on your system where you have a permission via a single command line. Very useful. So we press enter and there we go. It has indeed created them. You can confirm it by doing the listings. So downloads. There you go. So file 02 and 03. And you can see there's another file. It says find me. I have used it to conduct some tests previously. If I go ahead and type in documents, here you go. You see that the file 04 is indeed there. Let's go ahead and clear the screen and deal with the subject of two more commands, which is find and locate. We're going to deal with find first. You will use find only if you know where something is in specific. You definitely don't want to use find to search through your entire system, because that's going to take a while. not a pretty sight, I can tell you that. Not a pretty wait. But here you go. You can type in find. That's why we use locate, that uses a database that's much faster, that can search through the entire system at practically no time. So just you type in find, and then you're going to specify the directory in which you want it to search. You don't need to specify the directory. You can just go ahead and type in your search pattern here with an argument, but rather instead I want to specify a directory, because it would be highly inefficient to actually just say go ahead and search through the whole system. Although sometimes you need to do that, and that's why locate is so nice. I personally always use locate instead of find, but I just figured I would show it to you anyway. So let's say that I want to go into my home directory, and there I will conduct a search. So if I type in name, then space, quotation marks, I will say file 01. Search. Excellent. So it has found it relatively fast. It says home random guy file 01. It has been found indeed. But what if I did this? What if I change this letter to lowercase letter? Guess what? Nothing is found. It does not exist. Linux is case sensitive. I believe that I've mentioned this previously. If not, oh well. And two files having the same name, the only difference being lowercase letters and uppercase letters, are two completely different names for the Linux system. So it is case sensitive to the point of extreme, and you should all be very much aware of it. If you want to ignore the case, the usual argument for the commands which deal with text formatting is dash I. So you just add dash I to the name, and you see it has indeed found it. Usually dash I is to ignore something, generally, in all commands. Anyway, I could have just said, if I don't specify a folder path, it's gonna, oops, let's see, where am I at the moment? So pwd, okay, so I'm in home and random guy, and if I am in the current working directory where the file is located, and if I do this, it's gonna find it. But suppose I am not. Suppose I do go and change it to root. Oops, what has happened here? Well, first of all, we have been issued permission denied for a ton load of folders. If I do ll, we are unable to access most of these folders as our current users, so the find will not even be able to look for them there. That's the first problem. The second problem is that even though it can access the home directory, it hasn't actually found it, because it is only looking here. There you go. So all of these things are permission denied, you are unable to access it. Be sure that you execute a find command from a place where you have access to other folders and their subfolders. Please be aware of that, otherwise you will not be able to actually execute find at all. You will just get the same error that I have gotten. So Here you go. I typed in find, and it says iName, and it says file 01. Excellent. So it has immediately found it here in the home, even though I'm in my root directory, no problems. So it does jump in to the folders recursively, which is very nice. But look here, where it tries to look for the file, it says permission denied, permission denied, permission denied. You cannot access these files or folders. And provided that your file is in one of those places, it will not be able to find it at all. That can be extremely problematic. That's why we need root permissions, sudo and su. Later on we will deal with that, but for the time being I just want to show you this. Anyway, if I go ahead and clear the screen, there is another command which we can use, which is very nice. I personally prefer to use it. It's called locate. And if I just type in locate, so file 01. Oh, what is this? It hasn't found anything. What could be the problem? Well, as I said, locate uses a database, and that database is updated on daily basis, which is resource inexpensive, but also inefficient. However, the beloved Linux creators and the locate creators, developers, have left us with a very nice option here. It's called, you just type in update, updatedb, press enter. Cannot open temporary file. Oh yeah, okay, so one more thing. You cannot do the update without the root permissions. In order to obtain root permissions, well, there are, you just type in su, press enter, type in your root password. You're not going to see anything here. It'll be blank. This is done as a precautionary measure, and of course I've typed in the wrong password. You see, when I type in my password, nothing is shown. In Unix, Linux-like systems, every time you type your password into the terminal, usually 99% of the cases, the length of the password will not be shown. It will not show as though you're typing anything. Don't worry, it's not broke. It's just a security precaution so that if somebody's watching across your back, over your back, they won't be able to see the length of the password on the screen, which is a very nice feature, and I would very much like for Windows to implement it as well. Although it is not really practical, as I say, you just have to get used to it, because even though you're typing something, you can't see anything on the screen. I would also like some other services, for example, like Gmail or Amazon as well for cloud hosting and stuff like that, to actually implement that version of authentication so that the passwords are, so that the lengths of the password are not shown, because if somebody has the length of your password, the amount of possible combination reduces drastically. Anyway, now that we are root, let's go ahead and clear the screen. So you can see that I am no longer random guy. I am root at, this is my hostname. I'm going to change the hostname later on, but for the time being, this is the one. So I am logged in now as root at this hostname, at this machine. Let's type in updatedb. Excellent. And let's type in locate again. So locate. And what do we need? We need file 01. There we go. It has found it immediately. But look. You can type in dash dash help. And there is an ignore option here. There you go. Look, it is the same, exactly the same as with the find command. So dash I, clear, type in locate. Dash I, file 001. Okay, let's kill the capital letter. Excellent. So let's just change the name a little bit more. Let's type in like this. This. It's still gonna find it, so no problems. But let's say you don't know the whole name of the file. You just know the fragment of the name, or the portion of the name, or something of a kind. Well, that can be problematic. So what you want to do is type in locate dash I space, and here you can actually just type a fragment of the file name. So I don't know, let's say it's, wait, this is gonna give me too much stuff, but let me just show you. So file, look at how much stuff we got. And I don't want to sip through all of this, but I can assure you that the name is actually within this. However, you do need to actually filter it a little bit more. So let's say underline and a zero. There we go. It has indeed found what we were looking for, and in addition to that, what we were looking for, it has also found anything else containing this particular pattern. Anyway, the file is actually contained here as well, somewhere, God knows where, but if you don't actually know anything, if you just know a fragment of the name, then you're actually going to have to manually sip through this unless you are able to learn more or guess more about the name of the file. Eventually, if you sip through all of it, you will find it, God knows where, somewhere, I guess. But you can immediately, I mean, if you're looking for libraries or something of a kind, you generally know that they're in user share, lib, somewhere of a kind. Or if you know where you've approximately saved something, you don't need to search through the entire file system. You can just specify a path and then a name to the path. You can just specify a path. Hold on, I didn't show you how to do that with locate. Let me just do this. So locate file 0. And if I say home, okay, so has it actually been able to find anything? Yep, there we go. So in addition to a ton load of stuff, which is basically your home directory, as it has taken that as a search pattern as well, it has actually managed to find this. But this is not what we're looking for. This is not good enough because it is taking the folder path as a search parameter. So it's giving us more results than we generally need. So this is no good. What we need is the help menu, so dash dash help, and we need to actually find a way to exclude the path to the file. I'm sure it is here somewhere, so let's take a look at it. I have an approach so that I am putting myself in your shoes, and this is how you would do it if you wouldn't know how to do it in the first place. This is how you would learn how to do it. So basically, what do we have here? You always go to the help and you figure out from there. We have A. What does that do? Only print entries that match all patterns. Nope, that's not really. Match only the base name of the path names. This could be it. Only print number of found entries. Use database. Only print entries. Nope, that. Ignore for backward patterns. Nope, let's just use the B option. So, dash dash, dash B, and let's go to home, and then space, and then file, I don't know, zero. We'll play around with it more. Excellent. So what have we gotten here? It says in the ups, my mouse seems to be running away a little bit. It says B, base name. Match only the base name of the path names. Very simple. So it will just find the last entry, and that will be it. Excellent. So within home folder and within all subdirectories of that folder, please look for anything, any pattern that contains, please find any file that contains this particular pattern which we have given it. So if you compare, let's say, this to this, it's a lot shorter, right? You have significantly downsized the amount of possibilities. Very useful command. People use it on a daily basis. Just don't forget to update the database. It is necessary for you to do so if you want to find stuff, because it is updated once a day and it's not enough. You just need to update it manually and you will solve the problem. There are ways to configure it to update on a more frequent basis, but there is no need. You're just consuming resources. Rather, instead, just type in updatedb and it's going to be done in milliseconds. Then find whatever it is that you are looking for without any problems whatsoever. Anyway, I bid you all farewell until next time.